Do you really know how to use LightBurn? Did you know there are 238 pages in LightBurn documentation? For today's video, we went through those pages so you don't have to. Whether you're a LightBurn veteran or just an average enjoyer, Hotkeys significantly saves your time and sharpens your skill. On page 140, there are four whole pages of hotkeys and gestures. We selected a few here, however, feel free to consult the document itself for reference. Here's a little joke we found in the document. One of the most common use case for LightBurn is engraving photo or images. You can use contrast, brightness, and gamma in image settings to remove some unwanted noise or shading in the background. And minimize your editing process for better results. Enhance radius and enhance amount settings will sharpen your engraving result. Some adjustments here could really make your engraving pop. However, over tweak it, you will lose some details. LightBurn is perfect for hobbyist and standard machine setup, so we ensure a trouble-free and smooth transition for every machine we tailored for our customers. However, for industrial-grade laser cutters, this is not the case. Here are some custom modifications that a LightBurn might not be compatible or can't fully utilize. With those set up, LightBurn might not be your first choice. Contact your laser manufacturer for custom-made software with better compatibility. On page 26, you will see that why LightBurn is one of the best software compared to these. Before we end this video, here are some tips and tricks. If you point the mouse cursor at a button or window and press F1, LightBurn will launch your browser and open the documentation on the relevant help page for that control. This works for nearly all controls on the main window. Sometimes a window gets shoved off the screen or positioned in a way that makes it hard to find or move. You can reset the window layout in LightBurn in two different ways. In the window menu, choose Reset to Default Layout. This will undock all windows and redock them in the default order. If that doesn't do it, restart LightBurn while holding Shift. This skips restoring the saved window layout and always works. Setting up a new computer can be a pain, especially if you put a lot of time and effort into adding machines and configuring your LightBurn installation exactly how you like it. To avoid repeating all that work, you can export your preferences on your old computer using File Export Prefs, and then import them on your new computer using File Import Prefs. For more tips, you can find them in page 28 of the LightBurn document. Hey, tell us what you want to see next, and don't forget to like and subscribe because we are sending more great content your way.
Well, it was nice catching up. Let's get to business.